On the surface, India and Israel seem very different. They have different religions, cultures, histories, and very different sizes. The entire population of Israel can fit inside the city of Mumbai, but these two nations actually have some surprising similarities. Let's begin with how both modern states came into being. In 1947, India became a country, and in 1948, Israel declared its independence. In both cases, the formerly British-controlled areas had borders that were simply drawn up on a map by diplomats. Yes, they literally took a pen and drew a line to divide the new states. India was created with Pakistan, and a Jewish state, which would become Israel, was drawn with an accompanying Arab state. As you may know, pen partitioning didn't go too well. Both Israel and India were immediately engulfed by war with their neighbors. India went to war when Pakistan invaded the state of Kashmir, which had decided to remain separate and not join Pakistan or India. And as soon as Israel declared its independence, surrounding Arab states attacked it, with both Israel and India gaining territory in these defensive wars. But that's neither the beginning nor the end of India and Israel's surprisingly similar stories. Their relationship begins with food. Evidence in burial sites in Megiddo from around 2000 BCE show that Bronze Age Israelites were flavoring their food with sesame and turmeric from India. Later, that trade route extended past Israel to the Western world. If you enjoyed exotic foods or aromatic incense in Caesar's Rome, chances are they came from India through the land of Israel. The second millennium BCE also saw the formation of two of the world's oldest religions, Hinduism and Judaism, in the lands of India and Israel. Scholars date the writing of the Hindu sacred texts known as the Vedas to around 1500 BCE, around the same time that Jewish tradition holds the Bible was given to Moses, and both contain stories and traditions that go back much further. They also each served as the foundation for other prominent religions. Judaism's texts and traditions form the basis of Christianity and Islam, and Hinduism birthed Buddhism and Jainism. Interestingly, while over the next few millennia and even up to today, Jews mostly had a tough time living under Christian and Muslim rule, India showed Jewish immigrants tolerance and peace. Fast forward to the 17th century, and both the land of Israel and much of the Indian subcontinent are under Muslim imperial rule, Israel by the Ottomans, and India by the Mughals. Then came the British. Almost all of India came under British rule in the mid-19th century, and mandatory Palestine was established under the Crown following World War I. After the Second World War, and as the British Empire contracted, they divided their colonies with plenty of pens, but perhaps without enough thought to the religious and ethnic divisions. So now we're back to our time, where despite all of the historical similarities, these modern nations have actually had a pretty complicated relationship. If the governments of Israel and India got along as well as Albert Einstein, one of Israel's most prominent proponents, and Jawaharlal Nehru, India's first prime minister, things would be great. The two met in Princeton University and really admired each other. In 1947, Einstein wrote to Nehru and asked him to support the emerging state. Nehru couldn't do it, though. The young India didn't want to alienate its Muslim citizens in support of a Jewish state, especially when it had its own neighbors to worry about. Interesting side note, Nehru had a Jewish relative, the wife of his cousin, B.K. Nehru, known affectionately as Auntie Fori. Jewish historian Martin Gilbert's letters to her are the basis of his book, Letters to Auntie Fori. Learn more about them in our video by clicking on the card or on the link in the description. Back to India and Israel. Though Israel has provided military aid and traded informally with India since the 50s, it wasn't until after the Oslo Accords that they began to formally cooperate, and relations have only gotten better since. Today, India's government maintains a policy of de-hyphenation, treating the Israeli government and Palestinian Authority as separate and engaging with each on its own terms. With the rise of terrorism, the countries share much in defense technology. Since India and Israel both deal with territorial disputes and conflicts over holy sites, the governments share information and technologies, like smart fences and drones. And of course, both countries shared sorrow and resolve after the November 2008 Mumbai attacks, when a Pakistani terrorist group attacked sites around Mumbai, killing hundreds of people who called India home, including the Israeli founders of Mumbai's Nariman Chabad House. But regardless of governmental policy and defense needs, it just seems that the people of each country like each other. Israel is home to a population of Indian Jews, including a few who still speak Judeo-Malayalam, the Indian equivalent of Yiddish or Ladino. And across polls conducted in the last 20 years, India is ranked as the country most favorable to Israel. India is one of the most popular destinations for young Israelis who travel on their post-military trip. The low cost, beautiful sights and vibrant nightlife attract so many of these tourists that their regular route through the country is affectionately called the Humus Trail. Both countries are also making great advances in technology. Global tech companies like Google, Microsoft, Apple, and others often choose Israel or India as their R&D locations. India's Bengaluru, commonly referred to as Bangalore, and Israel's Tel Aviv are working to become new Silicon Valleys. And Silicon Valley itself is home to many Indian and Israeli expats. Companies from both countries have also worked together on agriculture, medicine, and entertainment. Israel, located in a water-poor region, is bringing its advanced irrigation and agricultural technology to help Indian farmers grow more food with less. In 2018, India even filmed its first Bollywood movie in Israel. And in 2021, Israeli and Indian pharmaceutical companies started co-developing and testing an oral COVID-19 vaccine. Perhaps the reason that Israel and India are getting along so well is because both countries share a kind of entrepreneurial can-do attitude, what Indians call jugaad, and what Israelis might call a shiftsur, the ability to find non-conventional solutions and even hacks to problems with limited resources. As former Israeli President Reuven Rivlin said on a visit to India in 2016,
jugaad is the way we think, the way we invent, the way we work.
It's an attitude that's helped both countries prevail when the odds are stacked against them, and it might just be the biggest similarity between these two very different nations.